Wow, what an amazing week, isn't it? Morning, everyone. I'm Bill from Huawei. I'm super excited to be here to share with you some of our observations. The title of my speech is Cloud Native 2.0, Uplift Productivity with Openness and Innovation. So what's the cloud native evolution and the challenge we are facing today? According to Gartner, so by 2025, the digital economy will generate more than 500 million applications and software, and 90% of which are cloud native. But the bar chart below shows here in 2021, the total market size of the non-soft cloud software still 50% bigger than the entire cloud market here in Europe. So that means adopting cloud in all industry should still be the target of our cloud native community. So there are three evolution trends we observed. First, expertise as a service. So that will enable the cloud migration of industries. Second, technology as a service. So this will accelerate the application modernizations. Third, infrastructure as a service. This will make the cloud accessible globally. So there are two challenges. Number one, so how to bring the cloud native technology from internet digital first business to the traditional environment. Second, so how to combine those openings and innovation of cloud native with the productivity of the industry. So I will talk open and innovation one by one. The innovation. Here I would like to say several cases of how to explore the new boundaries of the cloud native. SAC Maxis is one of the automotive companies in China. They use the Cooper Edge to connect their vehicles as a node to the cloud. They could manage more than 100,000 of vehicles per cluster. BUPT, Beijing University of Post and Telecommunication, they use Cooper Edge in satellite. So the calculation precision is improved 50%. And the data sent back from the satellite and reduced by 90%. Xiaohongshu is like the Pinterest in China. They use the enhanced volcano scheduling to improve their balance their task process. And this gives them the AI training throughput improved by 20%. And ING, International Netherlands Group. So they are struggling when switching from the Hadoop platform onto Kubernetes. So the volcano helps them to improve their scheduling performance by nearly 10%. Openness. So here we can see there's a huge gap between cloud native industry with the traditional industry. So initially, we really start cloud native in internet and the digital business. So the step by step, the traditional industry also evolved cloud. They start from this financial service and then follow with industry 4.0, video conference, education, automotive. And last year, we initiated this open service cloud project to enable this open, manageable, and portable managed service cross clouds. So fusion the gap is quite important because it's in our cloud native community. We're always chasing the latest technology like WASM. But in industry, the really problem is not the technology, but the business scenarios, just like how to improve the manufacturer efficiency. So this gave us the Huawei's latest open source project called Quasar. So what is Quasar? Quasar is a very bright and energetic celestial body in space, which spins very fast. So speed and efficiency is quite important in container runtime as well. So that's why we name this project as Quasar start with letter K. So as we know, there are many sandbox container technology, which just like a microwave application kernel container and the OneStream container. But none of them could solve the requirement very well. So with those pain points here, Quasar provides three benefits. Abstraction. The sandbox API could provide a unified user experience. Collocation. So the pre-integrated runtime enables this, deploy this hybrid multiple sandbox, which ensures the isolation, the security, the speed, and the user resource efficiency. The optimized framework, the fully Rust implementation achieved 2x the speed and 99% of overhead reduction. So the Quasar is open and neutral. Welcome to scan the QR code here and visit the repository in GitHub. So welcome to join and try it. So Huawei Cloud will continue to play three roles in the community. As a pioneer, we are the first company to bring cloud native to China and the only CNCF founding member in Asia. So we also facilitate the events with the community called Cloud Native Elite Club in China, Brazil, Thailand, and Spain. As an innovator, we released the world's first multi-cloud container platform, MCP, the all-fledged cloud storage engine, and also this next generation container cluster, CCTuber, as well as this distributed cloud native UCS. So as a contributor, we are ranked number one in Asia by the code we committed to Kubernetes and Istio. So we also contribute to those KubeEdge, Volcano, Kamada project to the community. So we truly believe the openness and the innovation will thrive in our ecosystem. So Huawei Cloud, we need to work with our partners to continue deliver the value to the industry. So together, we uplift the productivity with openness and innovation. So with all that, thank you for your listening. Thank you.